But you know, this is kind of an explosive time for Trans Am, because now the manufacturers get it, that if we build cars with the Trek hardware on it and sell them enough to homologate, well then guess what, we might have a better shot at winning. So Trans Am cars went from basically cars you bought off showroom floors to very selected editions. Boss 302s, Z28s, and Trans Am Firebirds were really all invented to generate that side of success. The Firebird, my father had been racing for Ford. The Firebird, John DeLorean, talked to my dad, talked to Shelby, talked to a lot of people, got my father to come over. Shelby did not go with him, and decided we're going to get Pontiac up front as well. We go to Royal Pontiac and pick up this car, very, very early car in production, like in the first 11 and probably number two or three in that group that were built, really is kind of litmus tests of the development of these cars. So now we bring this car back, we start to fix it up. I assume this is going to be one of the cars we strip to turn into a race car. As it turns out, the car has other responsibilities, and we pick up five, maybe six, but probably five standard street, bare bones, three on the tree, six-cylinder Firebirds, and those are the cars we ultimately strip that we get from Royal Pontiac. It turns out my father's actually using this thing to drive around. But it became an important car in my family. First of all, I liked it parked out front. That looked pretty cool.